In these two examples, we're asked to evaluate the common logarithms using a calculator. The reason we're asked to use a calculator is because notice how the number part of the logarithms cannot be written as 10 raised to an integer power. So we'll have to get decimal approximations for these common logarithms. So for the common log of 110, with the calculator, we'll press the common log, which is this button here, 110, close parenthesis, and press enter. We're asked to round to 4 decimal places, so this will be approximately 2.0414. But I do want to emphasize what this means. Remember, this is common logarithm, which means this is log base 10. So when evaluating a common logarithm on the calculator, we're determining the exponent, which we raise 10 to get the number 110, meaning 10 raised to the power of 2.0414 is approximately equal to 110. We know it's going to be approximate because we did have to round this value. And since we did round up, this value should be just a little bit larger than 110. Let's go ahead and check this. We have 10 raised to the power of 2.0414. We can see it's very close to 110, just a little bit larger. Now let's take a look at our second example. We have the common log of 0.425. So we'll press the log key, 0.425, close parenthesis, enter. This value is approximately negative 0.3716. Again, this is the answer that they're looking for. And again, I want to emphasize what this means. This is common log, so it's log base 10. So 10 raised to the power of negative 0.3716 will be approximately equal to 0.425. Let's go ahead and check this. 10 raised to the power of negative 0.3716, as we can see, is approximately 0.425. So while it's easy to get these values, but I think it's important to remember when evaluating logarithms, we're actually finding exponents. I hope this was helpful.